Hi, this is Freddy from Switzerland with another knife review, and today we're going to take a look at another knife from Kizer Knives out of China. So as you know, Kizer is a more higher-end Chinese company that builds a lot of titanium frame lock folders with S35VN steel. And the knife we're going to take a look at today is one of my favorite designs from them. It's a little bit an older model overall, but I'm really a fan of this one and also had this now for quite some time. And the model that I'm talking about is the Kizer Splinter. Really good looking, slender overall design, really up my alley on EDC preferences. You have a long blade but still an easy to carry and very slender overall package here. Gorgeous design with this pattern that they milled into the titanium, and you also have a 3D milled titanium clip. So overall, really a knife that attracted me from the first time I saw it. And now let's take a look at the specs of this knife. So we have an overall length of 7.5 inches or 19 centimeters. That gives us a blade length of 3.375 inches or 8.5 centimeters. The steel is S35VN. And we also have a blade thickness of 3 millimeters that also tapers very nicely to the point here in the front. And then we have a handle length of 4.125 inches or 10.5 centimeters. So a really great EDC size. Nice in hand, you can see my small to medium hands, it fits really well. I even have a little bit of space left here in the back, and it also feels quite ergonomic. So overall, a really interesting design. And now let's take a look at the weight of the Kizer Splinter. And it weighs 73 grams or 2.55 ounces, so a pretty lightweight overall knife, especially considering the over 3-inch blade that you have here on the Kizer Splinter. And that is also really remarkable because they have actually not skeletonized the scales or anything, and you also have quite a massive titanium backspacer. So overall, I think if they skeletonized the titanium scales, it would even be lighter. But as it is right now, with well under 3 ounces, I think it's a really good EDC weight, especially for the blade length you're getting here on the Splinter. So overall, nothing to complain on the weight of this knife. Now let's take a closer look at the 3.375 inch long S35VN blade. And you can see here we have a very interesting and unique blade shape. I would call that a modified Warncliffe blade shape. You also got a nice pronounced swetch here in the front that really makes this knife look very aggressive. And of course you have your nearly completely straight cutting edge here that makes it a Warncliffe. You also have a gorgeous stone washing here on the blade, as you can see. Really well done. And then you have your regular Kizer markings. You have the logo of the company there, then the steel S35VN, and your model number as well. And if you flip it around, we can take a look at the other markings here. You can see the name of the knife, Splinter, and that it is designed by Tomcat Knives out of the US. So maybe the Tomcat Knives logo could be a little bit smaller and together with the Splinter here in the flat part. Other than that, we have a flat grind here that starts very, very high up. It's nearly a full flat grind. You only have this little flat portion and the swetch at the front. So it's going to be quite a thin blade here. You can see here from the ricasso that it is quite thin behind the edge and also nicely ground. You also have a sharpening choil. There is a slight bit of flaring out here at the end, as you can see. But you still have a nice sharpening choice, so it's easy to sharpen the whole length. And because it is a straight edge, it's quite easy to sharpen as well. The initial sharpness out of the box was not perfect. It was sharp here in the back part, but then about from here to the tip, it was not as sharp as in the back. I don't actually know what went wrong there, but it is not as sharp in the tip area as here in the back, but that should be easily modified, and it would still cut paper in the front as well as in the back, so not that big of a deal. But the initial sharpness out of the box could be slightly improved. You don't have any jimping here at the top. I would like to see that, of course, but other than that, I'm really a fan of the long and slender blade shape here on the Splinter. Really good looking, and a nice achievement of packing in this long of a blade in an overall 7.5 inch blade. Now let's take a closer look at the handle construction and design. And you can see here that you have a very, very good looking full titanium handle here on the Splinter with this interesting milling that they have done on the front scale to give it a little bit more traction and also provide a very attractive look, in my opinion. You don't see a lot of titanium knives, especially in this price point, that have such intricate milling done to them. And you also will find that on the back side, even on the lock bar. So really, really good looking and well executed pattern here. And also it provides a little bit of grip as well. So I'm really a fan of the milling that they have done on the titanium scale here on the splinter. Other than that, you can see you have a Torx construction, your regular slightly customized Kizer pivot screw right there, and then your quite large three screws here in the back that hold the backspacer in place. Maybe these three screws are a little bit of an overkill from a functional perspective, but I think it looks quite nice. It just adds a little bit of a design feature here as well. You can also see that the finish on the titanium is some kind of a bead blast finish, which I actually really like, but you can see it certainly attracts some scratches. But I had it now for quite a long time, and the only few scratches I have is here near the pivot, and then I dropped it once, and you can see here on the back there is a little bit of markings and scratches, but very minimal. So I think it's a pretty durable finish that they have put here on the splinter. You also have a lanyard hole here in the back, which is done really interestingly, because you can see that they actually have chamfered also the end of the hole right here. So actually your lanyard would rest nicely here in this scale and wouldn't be standing out in this dimension as much, because they run this channel right here. I haven't seen that on any other knife so far. You also can see here that you have a slot for your 3D milled titanium pock clip that you can actually swap from tip up left or right hand carry. So that is certainly a nice thing for your lefties, but I personally would have liked to see no slot there or a filler tab or anything like that. But in this price point, I can really see why they went that route. Other than that, we have a flush titanium backspacer that is really nicely fitted. So you can see there are no gaps, nothing is standing over, everything on this knife is fitted very well. And if you take a look at the pocket clip again, you can see it is a nice 3D milled titanium pocket clip with a nice slot mill here in the inside, and it is held in by a single screw, and of course it is embedded into the scale like here on the other side. So very well done there, and it also works really well. It has enough spring tension, but it is not too hard to get in and out of the pocket, even though it lands on this more textured titanium, but I hadn't any problem. It carries about like this, as you're going to see in the inlay photo, so not too bad. Quite deep carry, especially for a milled titanium clip. So I actually like that they went this route here with the milled titanium clip, and it certainly adds to the overall look of the knife, in my opinion. The lock of the knife is of course a frame lock, as you can see here. The frame lock cutout is a little bit sharp. I hope you can see that, and also this little point can sometime poke you a little bit, but I hadn't had that much of an issue with that actually in gripping the knife. So maybe that depends on the thickness of your fingers. But other than that, you have a full titanium frame lock, and you can see here that you don't have any steel insert, and that is certainly a thing that I would like to see on a second edition of the splinter, just to give the lock a little more longevity. I haven't had any issues with the lock so far. It locks up perfectly. There is no stick. There was never any stick. So no problem there. But it will certainly be a nice addition. You can also see that they nicely chamfered the lock bar, so it's really easy to disengage. And you also have a little bit of a cutaway here from the show scale, so it's really easy to disengage that lock bar. So very well done there by Kizer. So overall, I'm really a fan of the handle design and construction. It also fits the hand really well, as you can see here, really ergonomic. You get a little bit of grip because of the milling there, and it just fits the hand very well. So now let's take a closer look at centering action and deployment of this knife, and you can see here that this knife is dead centered. Really well done by Kizer, nothing to complain there. And of course the deployment of this knife is provided by this really small understated flipper tab that lacks any kind of jimping or texturing. And because it is that small and has no texturing, you can actually slip up when you try to deploy this knife, because it also has quite a strong detent. So I would like to see some kind of texturing or jimping here on that flipper tab, but I actually like that it is so small and unobtrusive, so it's not going to bang into a lot of stuff in your pocket, and it also looks really sleek in the closed position. Other than that, the action is really well. You can see here it rockets out once you get a hang of it, of how to actuate that flipper tab. And it's also very, very smooth, as you can see here. So really nice overall action on the Splinter here. It also features a ball bearing system pivot. I'm not quite sure if it already has Kizer's ceramic ball bearing system and detent, or still the older stainless steel ones, because this is an older model from Kizer and I have it now for nearly a year, but it certainly has a really nice action, as you have seen here. So it actually doesn't matter that much. And I can also show you here the detent, which is really nice. It gets sucked in from very high up and it's a very, very solid detent, no play there. So very well done. Another thing that I noticed about this knife is also that the blade to handle ratio is very, very good. You can see that the blade comes nearly all the way to the end. There is just a little bit of titanium that protects your finger from catching that tip there. And I actually have sliced myself a little bit when I carry this knife on the offside, so on the left pocket, but still with the clip on the right side. So it was like this in my pocket and I reached in and I catched my hand like this a little bit and sliced it, but not really serious. But it's just a thing that you have to keep in mind, that there is not a lot that protects your finger from the point here of the Splinter. I can actually open it like that with my fingernail, so that is something to keep in mind. But I'm actually a fan of how much blade they put into the small handle here of the Splinter. Other than that, I'm really impressed with the action, especially for the price point of this knife. You get a very, very smooth action here with this ball bearing pivot, very comparable to its competition, and that all while having a rock solid lockup, so there's no up and down play, no side to side, absolutely rock solid. Like the day I got it. So really, really well done here on the construction and the action on the Kizer Splinter. Now let's take a look at the sharpness of this knife. So I now had it for nearly a year and had it in my EDC rotation certainly for about 3 months, and did all kinds of EDC tasks with it and was really impressed with the performance of this nice long and slender Wharncliffe style blade. And as I said before, it was a little bit sharper here in the back than in the front. I think you can also hear that, but when I'm getting to the front part, it gets a little bit rougher in the cut here. But overall, still quite sharp with the S35VN steel. I only stropped this knife, I never sharpened it. So quite impressive overall still with the performance of the S35VN here on the Kizer Splinter. So nothing to complain there. Can even do these squiggly line cuts. So very well done here on the heat treating of the S35VN, judging from its performance. Now let's take a look at the size comparisons that I like to do. As you know, I really like these small, slender gentleman's carry flippers, and I also have quite good comparisons for this knife. First off will be a knife from CRKT that is really similar to this knife, especially also in the blade shape, and that is going to be the CRKT Swindle, designed by Ken Onion. I've also reviewed this knife before. A really nice, more affordable version here of a small gentleman's carry folder. It features the IKBS ball bearing system and the Sandvik steel. And you can see size-wise, those two are very, very similar, as well as in the blade shape. So very good comparison here, and also a nice competitive option from CRKT. Of course, this is a steel frame lock and it's going to be quite a bit heavier overall. But if you are on a budget and searching for something like this, I think the CRKT Swindle is a nice one to look at. Then the next comparison I have for you is going to be from Böker Plus, and this is one of their most popular models in the last year, I think. It is the Böker Plus Urban Trapper, here in the Coco Bolo wood-handled version. And you can see here that size-wise, those two are also very, very similar. A really nice blade here. Here you have VG10 in contrast to the S35VN. Also titanium liners, and then you have your Coco Bolo overlay there. Also a ball-bearing pivot as well. And size-wise, very, very close. So also a nice competitive option here from Böker Plus, and this one is going to run you again a little bit cheaper than the Kizer here on the table. And the last comparison I have for you is going to be the ZT0450CF. So made in US by ZT, same steel, also a titanium frame lock. Here you are getting actually a steel insert, and you have, of course, your carbon fiber scale. So this one is going to be lighter than the Kizer, as well as the Urban Trapper. This is also going to be lighter than the Kizer Splinter. But here, of course, you're going to pay quite a bit more than for the Splinter. And of course, aesthetics-wise, it is something very, very different. Now let's talk about value and price and come to a final conclusion about this knife. So if you want to get yourself your own Kizer Splinter, you're going to pay just under $125. Depending on where you're getting it, it probably can vary a little bit. I will leave a link to my recommended retailer, White Mountain Knives, in the description below. Go check him out, especially if you're from outside the US. He has really nice international shipping charges, and also is a really nice guy to deal with. And the shipping is also quite fast, I have to say. So for that amount of money, I think the Kizer Splinter represents quite a good value. You get S35VN steel, you get a nice heavily milled full titanium frame lock flipper with a ball bearing pivot and an overall really good craftsmanship. You can see here on the table some of my Kizer knives that I got so far. This one here is my newest one that is called the Guru. Really impressed with that one. I think Kizer is getting better and better and really provides a very good value when you're searching for a full titanium frame lock knife with a high performance steel and some ball bearings in them. It's certainly a good company to look at. So I am really, really pleased with my Splinter, and I would certainly recommend to check it out if you like the overall slender design. There is nothing on this knife that should hold you back, as far as I have experienced over nearly a year that I had this knife now. So this was my review of the Kizer Splinter. I hope you liked it. If you did so, please give it a thumbs up. And if you have any questions, please leave it in the comments below. And if you want to see more of these knife, gun and gear reviews, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching, have a nice day, and goodbye.